Let's have a look at the classic mode in the Sampler device. When you load a Sampler device into a MIDI track, you have three different modes to work with. The first mode is the classic mode. To demonstrate how this mode works, I have a drum loop clip to drag and drop into the Sampler. The classic mode allows a simple playback of any sample dropped into the Sampler device. And I can play this sample across the keys of my MIDI keyboard. The other important function of this mode is that with the loop mode selected to be on, when I reach the end of my sample, the sample will be looped back from the beginning and played again through its entirety until I stop playing the key. I can use the start and endpoint locators to select the size of the sample I wish to play back. In this case, I'm going to make the sample slightly shorter and zoom in so I can place my endpoint locator more precisely along the sample. I can change the endpoint of my sample at any time by simply grabbing the endpoint locator and moving its position. What you may notice is that when you drop short samples into the Sampler device, they are automatically warped in Sampler. What this allows me to do is to play back the sample at a different pitch but at the same speed. In this case, let's see what happens when I play the drum loop at a lower pitch. The sample plays back at the same speed as my master tempo, but at a different pitch. I can also make use of the different warp algorithms that are contained in the Sampler device, depending on the samples that I've loaded into the Sampler. This will optimize the audio quality for that particular sample as I play it across the keyboard. So let's look at another way of using the Sampler in the classic mode. I'm going to record a monophonic synthesizer that has no MIDI controls whatsoever, so that I can use the audio sound wave to play back the notes polyphonically using the Sampler device. I've set up an audio track and selected the right audio input from my audio interface so that I can record a single note from this monophonic synthesizer. Once I've recorded this sample as an audio clip, I'm going to load a Sampler device into a MIDI track and then simply drag and drop the recorded audio clip into the Sampler so that I can play back the sample. I'm going to set the start and end points of my sample using the start and end locators. And in this case, I'm going to switch off the warp function in Sampler. With the warp function switched off, the Sampler works as a conventional sampling device. And what this means is that the higher the pitch I play on my keyboard, the higher the pitch of the sample, but also the faster the sample will play back. And the lower the pitch I play on my keyboard, the slower the sample will play back. The number of voices that can be played back can be set here using the voices parameter. In this case, it's 6 voices. So I can actually play back a chord now. With the loop function on, I can also set a particular area within the sample that can be looped so I can create sustained notes and chords. I can choose a section of the sample using the loop parameter, and using the length parameter, I can set the actual section of the sample I wish to loop. And using the fade parameter, I can create a crossfade to create a smooth transition of the waveform looping. Looping samples correctly can take a little bit of practice. However, you can use it to your advantage to create some sonically interesting samples by finding loop sections that may not necessarily correspond to a perfect loop.